This illustration illustrates about oscillations in a diatomic molecule. Here we are given that a diatomic molecule has atoms of masses m1 and m2 and the potential energy between molecules at separation r between atoms is given by this expression, where a and b are constants and r0 is the equilibrium separation of atoms. Now it is saying if atoms are compressed toward each other and released, we are able to find the oscillation frequency of molecules. The situation is like this, if this is an atom X and this is an atom Y, which are connected by some bond in this molecule, the potential energy of bond as a function of R is given as A plus B R minus r0 whole square. Now in this situation, if we calculate the force acting between the two atoms due to which they are bonded. So we can directly write force between atoms is as force at separation r, we can write as magnitude of d over dr of the potential energy as a function of r. Here I'm taking it magnitude because direction I'm already aware of, this would be attractive force between the two. So on differentiating this, I'm getting 2b r minus r0. Now in this situation here we can see as f external on the system is 0. This implies here for a two body system when no external force is acting, we can write, we consider one atom at rest and other in motion, or we can call it in oscillations with respect to first with its mass reduced to reduced mass. The concept of reduced mass we have discussed in the fundamental concept videos, which is given as here we can write it mu, which is m1 m2 upon m1 plus m2. Here we can consider this atom X to be at rest and with the bond other atom is connected, and this would be oscillating about this point and it is under the influence of this force. So here we can write for a force varying with position, the angular frequency of SHM or oscillations for a small amplitude is given by, for a body which is oscillating under this, this is given by root of f prime r0, that is first derivative of force at the position of equilibrium divided by m, which is given by Taylor's method. We already discussed at fundamental level. On substituting the derivative of this expression at r equals to r0, so this will be 2b only. So the angular frequency can be given as root of this value will be 2b divided by mu, which can be written as root of 2b multiplied by m1 plus m2 divided by m1 m2. That will be the final result of this problem.